स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं
डिप्रेशन इज आउटकम ऑफ योर मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड फियर ऑफ डार्कनेस आई कैन टेल यू At least few thousand disciples have come out of depression or the insomnia problem. Just this one technique. This one technique I have seen in my experience. Of course, I have to use the legal disclaimer. Results may vary. Because I am talking in a legal country. Otherwise, I tell you, dharmically, I have seen only once this technique. People just transforming the quality of their sleep on day. If the quality of your sleep is improved, the quality of your day will be improved. You will have clear eyes, sharp eyes. Just yesterday, when we were driving in the car, in front of us there was a truck. There was a wordings, funny words in his bumper sticker. Very small letter. I may be rushing to hell, don't follow so close. Don't be so close. Means that if you go so near only you can read. When I read and I was telling my disciples, who was driving, he said, Swamiji, only because you told, I am even able to make out that word. The reason is, reason for the sharpness. Actually, after I started living in cities, my eyes have become a little dull. To tell you honestly. Of course, even though it is not, it's managing. The reason for the sharpness of the eyes is, I lived in a place where there is no artificial light. Lived more than 9 months without seeing any artificial light, man-made light, in the forest. That actually healed the eyes completely. Eyes completely got healed and returned back to the nature. Its own nature. Understand, this technique is nothing but bringing your body back to nature. 80% of your connection with the world happens only through eyes. If your eyes are brought back to nature, 80% of your being will be brought back to nature. You will be connected to the roots. I saw, when I lived without lights, not only I was able to see in the darkness, the number of thoughts has drastically reduced. Drastically reduced the number of thoughts. That's an important thing. Understand? Try this technique. It's a very powerful technique. In the night time, lie down in your bed and switch off the light. Let it be utterly dark, but don't fall asleep. You have to remain awake in darkness. Of course, in cities, you can never have the complete darkness. At least in India, whenever power cut, you can experience that complete darkness. Here, that possibility also is not there. You may have to go somewhere in search of darkness. Your eyes have to be open. And it should be completely dark. Dark sky. Unfortunately, in cities or the developed countries, the dark sky you will never be able to see. Because even at one corner or somewhere in the distant place, you will see the light. A small city will be there. In Himalaya, still we have some villages where you can experience the utter darkness. Utter darkness. If you can start seeing, penetrating the darkness, maybe if you go to the rooftop and look up in the sky, then there is a chance you will not see any light and you will see only the darkness. He says, in rain during a black night means the cloudy night. Penetrate the darkness. Enter that darkness as the form of forms. This is an important understanding. The word as the form of forms means behind every form, the base is darkness. Darkness is the screen on which the forms are moving. Kali is the basic energy, mother energy, on which the whole world is moving. The whole world is happening. Visualize darkness as a healing, motherly energy. There is a beautiful sloka in Taittiriya Upanishad. From the akasha came the air, vayu. From vayu, agni. From agni, apaha, water. From water, the earth. The sky, the space, is the base material out of which all the other four elements came out. But that sky is nothing but darkness. Means understand, the sky is not dead darkness. It is the darkness which is capable of giving birth to the whole cosmos, which was able to give birth to the fire, water, air and earth. Means the motherly sky energy, darkness energy, which is able to give birth. You need to have all these understandings, only then you will be able to meditate or visualize when you are entering into the darkness. Very powerful technique. This technique can heal three things: chronic fatigue and insomnia and depression. All these three straight away can be addressed and healed just by this one technique. Very powerful technique. I myself worked on this technique for 9 months. Very wonderful experiences happened. Opening up to nature will happen. The fear of the whole will disappear. As on now, I have seen many people afraid to look at the sky itself. They will be afraid to look into the sky. Because when you look into the sky, it's like from the height, from the 10th floor or 11th floor, afraid to look down. The moment you look down only, you will feel, you know for sure it's a strong parapet wall. You will feel as if somebody is going to push you from behind. Somebody is going to push you from behind. No. Just fear. Fear of that openness. Always, actually, for one moment you get a thought, why not disappear into that? Then you say, no, I can't disappear. Then it becomes fear. Same way the fear of the wholeness is an invitation for you to come back. And you say, no, I don't want to go back. I want to hold on to this chair. That is the fear. When you try to hold on to your chair, you will have the fear of the whole. I tell you, relax. Feel connected to the whole. Not only you will not have the fear, you don't have to go back anywhere. The enlightened beings are the beings who feel connected to the nature. Never go anywhere. Last statement of Ramana Maharshi is, where can I go? I am here. I'll be here. Understand, when you are connected to nature, you will be here. You are here and you will be here. Connecting with the darkness will remove the fear of hole, the fear of disappearing, fear of death will completely be healed. Your fear of death is nothing but the fear of darkness. Fear of unknown. Fear of unknown is nothing but fear of darkness. That is why in Tantra, first thing the disciples are told for healing is they are asked to go and sit in one forest or empty space and gaze at that emptiness. That's all. In Zen, the person will be asked to sit facing the wall and face at the wall, gaze the wall. In Tantra, the person will be asked to go and sit in the emptiness, vast open sky, and whole night he has to gaze at the night, at the sky. You will see so many different fears and moods and everything coming up, whatever you suppressed. Everything will come up. Everything will open up. One important thing, if you have suppressed your need for rest, your desire to relax into silence, that suppression which has become restlessness in you will also come up. It will open up. It's like a whole thing will get cleaned. And that opening up only is like a fear. You feel, no. I don't want to look into this darkness. I don't want to see this darkness. You try to avoid. In rain during a black night, enter that blackness as the form of forms. Now we have one more problem. How to find dark night? And especially in the civilized, in the society, I am surprised. In the next sutra, Shiva gives a solution for this problem. I think he knows, after 5000 years, the civilization is going to be there, full of artificial lights, Thomas Alva Edison will be there, and he will discover the light, and human beings will forget about darkness. They will live in the society where the darkness will become very costly. The darkness will not be available. He is giving the next sutra, another wonderful technique. He says, when a moonless, rainy night is not present, when you don't have darkness, close eyes and find darkness before you. Opening eyes, bring the darkness out. Let the faults and fears disappear forever. I am really surprised. 5000 years ago, at least 5000 years ago, somebody who wrote this book can imagine maybe sometime there will be society where people even can't find the sky, which we say is always available, may not be available for the future generation. So he gives an alternative technique. The person, people who can't do this technique, naturally, people who are living in this country will not be able to do the first technique because you can't get the dark night. Very difficult. Only if you have the rooftop and you are in that high where your eyes does not or will not be attracted by the lamppost and the lights which are coming out of the cities, then you will be able to work with the darkness. If you are on the top of the hill, on the rooftop, maybe you will be able to work. Here Mahadeva is giving a beautiful alternative technique. He says, close eyes and find darkness inside. In the dark room, if you sit and close your eyes, you will be able to see the darkness intensely inside. Means, you cannot allow thoughts moving inside. If thoughts are moving, you will see light. Thoughts are light. If the light movement, color change is stopped inside, you will see only darkness and thoughtlessness. Thoughtlessness The color of thoughtlessness is darkness. Understand? Color of no mind is darkness. Because from the no mind thoughts come, same way, from the black color, all the other color comes. From the darkness, all other colors are coming. The color of thoughtlessness is darkness. Means Mahadeva is saying, bring yourself to the thoughtless state, just with the intense darkness. Sit with intense darkness for a few moments. By opening eyes, see the same darkness outside. It's a little tricky. Seeing the darkness with the closed eyes will be easy. Seeing the same intense darkness with open eyes will be little difficult. You may have to train yourself maybe for a month. It may take you a month to have that same darkness outside. You need to continuously throw that darkness out. Throw that darkness out. Means you need to bring the darkness outside. Visualize the darkness which is inside you is coming out. Somebody asked me, Swamiji, why in South India all the deities are carved with dark stone, granite, black granite? It looks so dark. I tell them, understand, subtle important message our masters are giving, the whole is dark. Meditating on darkness brings you down to the silence, no mind state. Even in North India, all Shivalingas will be in dark color only. All Shivalingas will be in dark color. Only the other deities will be in different colors. Shivalingas will be in dark color only. The darkness carries its own intensity. Meditating on darkness, resting in darkness is such powerful energy. I tell you, before falling asleep, before going to sleep, visualize the intense darkness. See the darkness residing in you. First thing, don't be afraid of darkness. Second thing, feel very friendly, connected to darkness. If you have the picture of a Kali in your room, it will be really helpful. You can remember the Kali is the embodiment of the darkness energy. Remember the motherly, healing, caring darkness energy, which is creativity, out of which things are created. Meditate on that intense darkness energy, not just dead darkness, which always you think the darkness which is there in the graveyard. No. Not the darkness of the smashana, graveyard, but the darkness of your mother's womb, out of which you came. Whether you want or not, every day you fall into the darkness, at least 3 to 4 hours in the deep sleep. If you 8 hours, at least 4 hours you may spend in deep sleep. If you spend 4 hours in the deep sleep, you are blessed. The deep sleep, what you are experiencing in the deep sleep, the same thing I am asking you to experience with consciousness, that's all. With consciousness, you are supposed to experience the same darkness. Here, all Mahadeva is saying, if I have to reduce to one line, experience the same state which you are experiencing in the deep sleep with consciousness, with awareness. Experience the same silence, same rest, same peace with awareness. In the deep sleep you have rest but not awareness. Here Mahadeva is saying, have the deep sleep with awareness, restful awareness. Actually, deep sleep and samadhi, only one difference. In deep sleep, you do not remember you exist. In samadhi, you will remember you exist. That's all. If you can add this one quality that you exist into the deep sleep, you are enlightened. Straight away enlightened. Nothing else needs to be done. Nothing else is required. Very, I can say, shortcut to enlightenment. Mahadeva is giving here. Shortcut to enlightenment. He is asking us to meditate on Karana Sarira. You go, you have a different layers of body. The first layer is the physical body. You are carrying physically the flesh and bone. Second layer is the body, Prana Sarira, inhaling and exhaling, breathing layer. Third layer is your inner chattering. The fourth layer is your emotions. The fifth layer is the layer of deep sleep layer, Karana Sarira. The layer which you experience during the deep sleep, darkness, utter darkness. That's the fifth part of you. Your being is seven part. First part is physical part, the flesh and bones, blood. Second part, your breathing cycle. Third part, your inner chattering. Fourth part, your visualizations. Fifth part, the part, deep sleep part. The darkness in which you rest every day. The sixth part is a no mind state, which ordinarily we don't experience. Seventh part is the cosmic body. Sixth and seventh, normal people never experience. All normal human beings experience only till the fifth. Mahadeva is saying, enter into the fifth with awareness. That's enough. Sixth and seventh will automatically open. Fortunately, in sixth and seventh, no door. No door. There's a clear writing. This door should be kept open during occupancy. The moment you enter into that hall, the opening is available. You don't need to do anything. All you need to do, just enter. It'll open. Small story. One king, he did not have kids. So he wants to choose one person from the kingdom to put him as a king, train and put him as a king. He announced the whole kingdom together and he announced a challenge, competition. Whoever can open the doors of the court, his fort had a huge gate, maybe 100 feet tall. Don't think 100 feet tall is a story. Even the temple which is in my native place, 87 feet tall, single stone entrance. The whole thing they carved out of single stone, 87 feet tall. I was wondering, why did they have such a tall, huge entrances? Because the kings have to sit on the elephant and go without getting down from the elephant. It's called Gajadwara. Even for elephant, unsitting does not need more than 30 feet. Then I saw, even the chariots has to go and come out. The guards will be put in the chariot and the whole chariot will go inside and come out. Anyhow, this king announced a challenge. Whoever can open this door with an empty hand will become king. The whole kingdom gathered, not a single fellow tried. The moment they saw the door, they got frightened. Oh God, how can it be? How could this be opened? Because they have seen the door being opened by 2-3 elephants or with a lot of effort. They never saw the door being opened by one person. Nobody tried. One young man, he decided, why not give a chance, try. When he went and put his hand and just pushed, door automatically opened because it was never locked inside. It was never locked inside or sealed inside. Usually, the sides there will be sealed. It was not sealed. It just opened. Understand? The same way, when you enter into the fifth body, the sixth and seventh body will open automatically because there is no seal. There is no seal. Entering into the causal body, Karana Sarira, is the ultimate technique because after this your mind cannot function. This is the maximum space your mind can travel. That is why all the traditions which lived with nature, all their rituals are always done in dark night. The darkness, feeling connected to it, is such a powerful thing. It can completely heal you. And not only that, simple experiments you can try. If you are constantly looking at the light, powerful lights you can see in the night, you won't be able to sleep. Even if you close your eyes, too much will be going on in front of your eyes, inside you. But if you sat and gazed at the empty sky in the night time, you will see suddenly the number of thoughts has reduced drastically. And you are in a kind of a silence. You are in a kind of a settled mood. A person who is centered on darkness will always be strong. Very strong. But non-violent. The person who is centered on light, who can't relax in the darkness, he will be violent but weak. Violence is nothing but your actions which are trying to cover that you are weak. A strong person will never be violent because he doesn't have to prove he is strong. But the weak guy will always be proving. That is, he has to cover, he is weak. So he has to be violent. Small story. One guy comes to the bar, drinks, goes out. Suddenly he comes back inside again and shouts, "Who is the idiot who painted my car? Who is the idiot who threw paint on my car?" One gigantic guy, he stood up and said, "Yes, I threw. What do you mean?" 6'9", 6.9 inch, that guy is standing. This guy had the shock. "Oh, I just want to tell you, first coat is over. First coat has dried. I just want to tell you, first coat has dried." Understand? Based on the civilization built on strength. Showing strength, not having strength. Civilization which is built on having strength will always be non-violent. Civilization which is built on showing strength will always be violent. The Zen traditions or the Naga Sampradayas, the Naga Babas will be so powerful, so strong, but non-violent. During Kumbh Mela, you can see, even now, the Nagas playing. They will sit on the horse. Once Naga will be lying on the ground. In his eyes, they will keep the two potatoes on the eyes. This guy will be playing with a sword, sitting on the elephant, sitting on the horse, and just use the sword and cut half of the potato, which is on his eyes, without cutting the nose. And if you cut vegetables in your home, you will understand how difficult even to stand and hold the knife and cut the vegetable without cutting your finger. the power, strength, but non-violent. The civilizations which is built on having strength will be non-violent. Darkness, meditating on darkness, will bring that inner strength to you. It will bring so many psychological changes. I tell you, even your fears are nothing but the moments of the light inside you. If you can start being comfortable inside you in your darkness, suddenly you will see even the moments of your fears reduce drastically. Drastically it will reduce. Because the number of thoughts will come down. Understand this one technique. Actually, Mahadeva gives two techniques. The first technique, you may not be able to practice because you are living in the society. But second, you can practice. Let me now give the instruction exactly. First step, closing the eyes. This is a Dhyana Sutra. Means, you need to internalize and practice a particular part of your life. You need a special dedicated moments for this meditation. Means you need to dedicate half an hour or 1 hour specially for this technique. You can't be doing this when you are driving or sitting or walking or eating or seeing TV. No. There are techniques which you can do that way also. That's Nitya Sutras. These are Dhyana Sutras. You need a special time for this. Sit. First step. Closing the eyes. Second important step, closing the inside movement. Understand, we all know how to close our eyelids, but not the eyes. Closing the eyelids or eyeballs is different. Closing the eyes itself is different. Closing the eyes means stop seeing completely inside also. Usually, when you close your eyes, you will start seeing many things inside TV, the inner inside TV, which can never be switched off. It's constantly going on. When you are with open eyes, you see outside. When you are with closed eyes, you see inside. That's the problem. Close your eyes and completely stop seeing inside. Then you will see the intense darkness out of which you are born. See, the darkness which was there in your mother's womb, the same darkness you are carrying still in your inner space. One peace has come inside you. That is what we call life. The ether energy, sky energy, which is there in your mother's womb, out of sky the whole world came. One bit of sky energy is in your mother's womb, out of which you came. When you came, that one part from your mother's womb is already put in your inner space. That is there. If you close your eyes and stop seeing things inside, you will see the intense darkness. Just be with that intense darkness at least for half an hour. If your mind goes here and there, wanders, come back. Come back. Get back. Get centered. Be with the darkness. Be with the darkness. After half an hour, open your eyes. Bring that same darkness outside. This needs little training. Means, with your open eyes, see the same scene which you saw inside, the darkness. See the same thing with intensity, intensely. This may take a month of practice, but if you can see the same darkness outside and inside, you will see, you will be able to switch off your mind whenever you need. Understand? The ability to switch off your mind whenever you need liberates you from all problems all disorders related to mind, whether it is insomnia, chronic fatigue, or sleeplessness, or oversleeping, or depression. All these things are related to causal body. All disease related to causal body completely will be healed once you enter into the deep darkness inside and outside. Inside and outside. Try in the home, try even tonight. Sit in the dark room, try just for half an hour. Sit with darkness and try to bring the same darkness outside. At least for 20 minutes, you will see so much of healing happens inside, especially people who are having chronic fatigue or the insomnia, falling asleep too much or not able to sleep or depression. This will do miracles into your system. Physiologically and psychologically, it will just transform you. It will transform you. Very powerful technique. Try in your house. Understand, these techniques are not just for healing. They are straight enlightenment. When you work with them, you will see new doors opening. You going into the deeper and deeper levels of consciousness. So, understand these few words and try to make it as part of your life. Let you achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
स्वभाव चिन्मयानंदम कृपा पूर्णम जगत्पतिम हरिषड्वर्ग जेतारम नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे. स्वभाव चिन्मयानंदम कृपा पूर्णम जगत्पतिम हरिषड्वर्ग जेतारम नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे. स्वभाव चिन्मयानंदम कृपा पूर्णम जगत्पतिम हरिषड्वर्ग जेतारम नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे. स्वभाव चिन्मयानंदम कृपा पूर्ण